Hello. This week we are talking about something I get asked all the time.
And that is, how early can you take a pregnancy test?
Yes. And what are some of those first signs of implantation and early pregnancy? If this is your first time meeting us, I'm Sarah. I am a board certified OBGYN and first time mom.
I am Kurt. I'm a board certified pediatrician and first time dad.
And we are the Doctors Bjorkman. Welcome back to our channel.
Yeah, over the past 2 years, we've shared our journey with getting pregnant, mm-hmm. Sarah's first pregnancy, our parenthood journey, and all of these evidence-based tips mm-hmm. and tricks along the way.
Yeah. We recently have been talking about trying to have baby number two and our IVF journey and struggles with secondary infertility.
Yeah. And this week we're going to be talking about how soon you can find out if you're pregnant, whether you've used IVF or are trying to conceive naturally, yep. Some signs of implantation, and those super early pregnancy signs and symptoms.
Yes. I've taken so many pregnancy tests over the past year. Every 2 week wait, I was testing too early, and even though I am an OBGYN, I was looking at all those forums to see how early other people were getting their big fat positives and overanalyzing every symptom.
Yeah, you may have caught it. We've talked all about what's happening with egg and embryo during this first 2 week wait in our video that we're gonna link here.
Yes, as a quick recap, so around day 14 of the menstrual cycle, the ovary releases an egg that is captured by the fallopian tube. That is ovulation. And that's the big event that you are trying to time sex with in order to optimize your chances of getting pregnant. At this time, the fallopian tube kind of sweeps around the ovary to grab that egg when it's released, pulling it into the ampulla or upper portion of the fallopian tube in just 2 to 3 minutes.
Yeah. And there in the upper end of the fallopian tube, this egg meets the sperm for fertilization, yep. which usually occurs within 24 hours of the egg being released.
Yep.
The fertilized egg then hangs out there in the ampulla for about 3 days before making its epic 3-day trip down the tube to the uterus.
Yes. And those first 6 days aren't just about hanging out in the ampulla and then working your way to the uterus. So that fertilized egg, while it's making that journey, it is also preparing for implantation by growing and dividing and growing and dividing. So this allows that fertilized egg to become 2 cells and then 4 and so on until it becomes, you know, a 64 cell blastocyst and continues dividing, and at that point, it's already starting to differentiate into what will become the placenta and what will become the baby.
Yeah. Then over the next week, a complex series of events matures this blastocyst while it's implanting into the uterine lining. There's been studies that have shown that this happens on average around day 9, but could be anywhere from day 6 to day 12.
It is also around this time that the outer layers of cells of the blastocyst start secreting human chorionic gonadotropin, or HCG. This is the hormone you've been waiting for, because HCG is what makes your home pregnancy test turn positive.
Yeah. So what is exactly happening with implantation this whole time?
Well, basically that tiny embryo is burrowing into the uterine lining and kind of has to chew away at the uterus a little bit to be able to establish a connection and establish that blood flow.
Gotcha. So as you can see here, that final step of implantation mm-hmm. is invasion.
Yes.
Implantation is not perfectly understood,
no.
but it is a very complex process where that embryo must invade into the cells of the uterus to establish blood flow connection between mom and baby via the placenta.
Yeah. And you can imagine, this isn't necessarily a comfortable process. Often women will have some cramping 7 to 9 days post-ovulation or days post-ovulation as that embryo is really starting to burrow in. As the connections are being made, there might be a little bleeding or spotting too.
Hmm. So sometimes 10 to 14 or so days post-ovulation, women may have some bleeding or spotting and wonder, is this implantation bleeding?
Right. Or is it the start of your next period?
Now, the other big hormone at play during this time is called progesterone. Yeah. And progesterone is a progestation hormone.
Yes. So when you ovulate, the follicle that the egg was released from becomes something called a corpus luteum. And the corpus luteum is actually a very metabolically active little follicle, and it is responsible for secreting hormones to support implantation and an early pregnancy.
Now, the corpus luteum secretes progesterone to help the endometrium become receptive for an embryo. Yep. And if you get pregnant, this corpus luteum is going to continue to secrete progesterone until the placenta takes over, making more progesterone, which that transition usually happens around 8 weeks of gestation.
Correct. So early pregnancy symptoms are often caused by that rising progesterone and HCG.
Yeah, and some of those high progesterone symptoms can be things like
breast tenderness, feeling like your boobs are getting bigger,
food sensitivities, nauseas, or you may be more sensitive to certain smells.
Yeah, you may have appetite changes or bowel changes, bloating, constipation, diarrhea.
Or also headaches, mood changes, or just a general feeling of fatigue. Yeah. Now, sometimes it can be really tough to tease out if these symptoms are from real pregnancy or if it's just part of your normal menstrual cycle, or if you're on progesterone as prescribed by your doctor as a part of an IVF treatment.
Right. Some patients experience all of these symptoms, cramping, bloating, bowel changes, headache.
But some experience none at all.
Right. So this brings us to the question, you know, how early can you get a positive pregnancy test?
Yeah, and the answer to that really seems to depend on how sensitive your home pregnancy test is, right?
Yes. The sensitivity of home pregnancy tests vary by brand. Some are supposed to detect an HCG as low as 6 to 10, and some are more like in the 25 to 50 range.
As we explained before, the embryo does not even start secreting HCG until it implants in the uterus, right, which is usually somewhere between 6 and 9 days after you ovulate. So even if fertilization has occurred and everything is going perfectly, there won't be any HCG in your bloodstream or urine until a day or two after implantation.
Because of this, the earliest we usually see a positive on a home pregnancy test is around 8 days after you ovulate.
Yeah. So any testing much before that is usually not recommended, and it's really just kind of a waste of money, and it can be totally unnecessarily disappointing.
Yeah. The other thing to think about is if you are doing any kind of fertility treatments or IVF, often you will take a trigger shot, which is HCG, and that would turn a home pregnancy test positive. You need to make sure that you have waited long enough time after that trigger shot to take a home pregnancy test, or you could end up with a false positive from that injection.
Yeah. Now, some people will take a pregnancy test every day after that trigger shot to follow it down.
Or test out, test it out.
And watching this line get lighter every day, and then hopefully watching the line, that second line, get darker again after that.
Yeah. But again, that's a lot of testing and a lot of anxiety.
Yeah. So now, what happens if someone got an embryo transfer?
Well, nowadays, most embryo transfers are done on day 5. And a day 5 embryo is called a blastocyst. And we know that after they're put back in the uterus at the transfer, they usually implant in the first 24 to 48-ish hours. Once implantation happens, then after that, that embryo starts secreting HCG. So you might get a positive home pregnancy test as early as day 4 or 5.
So the big takeaway that in a natural cycle, conceiving naturally at home, you might get a positive home pregnancy test on post-ovulation day 8 or 9.
But just because you don't does not mean you're not going to be pregnant that cycle.
Yeah. And then after embryo transfer, you might get a positive home pregnancy test as early as 4 to 5 days post-transfer.
Correct. But again, just because it isn't positive does not mean that you aren't going to be pregnant. And most clinics actually, if you're doing IVF, will tell you do not do your pregnancy tests at home.
Yeah.
So I am a bit neurotic, whatever, when it comes to testing. And when trying to conceive the old-fashioned way, I would usually start secretly testing around post-ovulation day 6 or 7.
Really?
Yes. And yes, I know that's really probably too early to get a positive, but I read on some of these forums that there are people out there that get a big fat positive on day 6 or 7, and you never know. With my first pregnancy, I got a faint positive, a squinter on DPO 10, so 10 days after ovulation, got a squinter, and then...
That I wasn't told about.
And then on day 11, definitely had a positive that if you watch our video of when we found out with that one, I actually knew at first. Yeah. But anyway, so I'm go a little wild when it comes to testing. And I think over the last year of...
Yeah, I think the downside of that is for all of the times we weren't pregnant with the second go around, it was a lot and a lot of negative tests.
Yeah, and we recorded many videos of us, you know, like, let's do this pregnancy test reveal for YouTube, and they were negative time and time again. So yeah, it was a year of an excessive amount of negative pregnancy tests. So with IVF, I guess, I did all of the things your clinic tells you not to, as you know, they generally...
She's the best patient.
Yeah. ...recommend that you don't do home pregnancy tests. You just take your blood test, usually 10 to 12 days after your transfer. And the reason for that is just because you get a negative on day 4 or 5 or 6 or whatever doesn't mean it is going to be negative. So they try to save you a little bit of that emotional roller coaster and disappointment when it's not necessary, which I learned very well. So on transfer day, I took a pregnancy test to test out my trigger, make sure it was negative, because I had taken a HCG trigger. It was like 1,500 units the 7 days before. So I was like, this should be completely negative. That trigger should be out of my system. Took a pregnancy test, negative. Great. And then, like a bozo, 2 days post-transfer, decided to take a pregnancy test in the morning, like just knowing it would be negative, but just for kicks and giggles. Well, sure enough, put a pic, it looked like there was a squinter, a very, very faint line. I sent it to my doctor, who's also like one of my dearest friends, and we analyzed over this together, and we're like, no, that's really there. We see this. I took another test that night, like the evening of post-transfer day 2 in the evening, and it also, like, I don't think we were imagining it. You can see. And so that was, you know, so exciting. And then I, wanting to watch these lines darken, on 3 days post-transfer, I took another test in the morning, and it was negative. Very negative. Another test was very negative. And that, I was pretty devastated. I, like, rationally, my doctor, OBGYN fertility doctor brain said, it's way too early.
Way too early.
Calm down. It's fine. That the positive the day before was probably from your trigger or something, like, mm-hmm. That probably wasn't real, just to keep breathing. So then on day 3, I went and got a blood test because I was like, we both saw it. It was positive. There was a squinter. It's got to be 5 or something. Anyway, the HCG level was less than 2, the blood test. So that was very real negative. And again, I was still pretty bummed.
Yeah, and I think we were apart for this. Like, we were both traveling for work.
I left shortly thereafter for a conference, yeah.
And, like, it was actually, like, tougher to go, like, having gone through IVF and then thinking we failed.
Or thinking it was positive and then it was negative, and it was, whew. So I went away to a conference, took boxes of pregnancy tests and a variety of different pregnancy tests, and Again, on day four, it was negative. And then on day five, we got this. And I texted Kurt a picture first thing in the morning. I showed my roommate. And she's like, yes, that's absolutely a positive. Texted it to my doc, texted it to my friend who was also there and had been giving me injection, my progesterone injections. And we were like, this is a positive. It is 5 days post-transfer. That is a real line. Yay, we're so excited. So then again, like a anxious, silly person who had too much access to care, on day six post-transfer, I got a blood test done again, and my HCG was 36. So we're like, okay, this is real. Then, like a normal patient, I got my blood work done 10 days after transfer, and it was a good, normal post-transfer HCG, and we were like, this is happening.
The theme of the story is if you do what you're supposed to, you avoid loss of anxiety and hopefully get an answer that is true.
That is true.
With one test.
Yes.
Okay.
So we are having another baby and we are so excited.
Yeah.
It's been so different. Just the whole process, obviously.
IVF, and then also just baby number two.
Yes, but while I tell all of my patients, while you didn't get pregnant the old-fashioned way, now you are just pregnant. And so that's where we're at. We're excited to share the journey of what pregnancy number two looks like, how that goes wrangling a toddler
who is determined and active.
Yes, and so we are looking forward to sharing that with all of you.
That is all we're going to have for you this week.
Hopefully it gives you some peace of mind and saves you a few bucks on excessive pregnancy tests.
And as you saw from our IRL, we are pregnant again.
Here we go.
So please continue to hang out with us as we go through pregnancy number two.
We will see y'all next week.
Bye, guys. We're doctors.
But not your doctors.
Anything we've said in this video is for education or entertainment purposes only.
It is not medical advice.
Any specific medical questions you have should be directed to your provider.